So you're going to be doing a group presentation through Adobe Connect. Here are some tips to make the process easier and make it look great. The first thing you're going to want to do is set up a dress rehearsal. This is going to allow you to work out some of the kinks in your presentation, like It's important, particularly to practice transitions, so that you know who the next person is speaking and you don't speak over each other and there are no awkward pauses. One of the easiest ways to do that is to just introduce the next person. Jason? Thanks, Jason. Another thing you're going to want to work out is who is in charge of the visual presentation on the screen. Now, if you're sharing your computer screen for the presentation, then it makes sense to have one person in charge of that to show the website or a presentation, slides, or whatever it is that's going on the screen, because that cuts down on needing to stop sharing with one person and then start sharing with another. However, if you're uploading a PowerPoint presentation into Adobe Connect and forwarding through those slides, it also makes sense to work out who is in charge of that. Who's in charge of that? Because if you've got more than one person, guys, two slides, one more. Okay. Because if you've got more than one person trying to forward through the slides, it can go forward too far. And that's just one of those situations where you've got too many cooks in the kitchen. Jason? Thanks, Jason. If you're going to be recording your presentation inside of Adobe Connect, you're going to want to give some thought to what you name the recording. Your professor is going to need to go back and find it later, so you don't want them viewing, let's say, one of your dress rehearsals. So make sure you put the word presentation in the name of the recording. Also, get used to some pfeffer incorporated. And that one of the things you... Hello? Dude, right in my ear. Dude, I said I was recording. So there's a strong possibility that you're going to have some sort of distraction during your presentation, a flub line, a dog barking, something of that nature, that's going to mess up the recording. Simply stop it and start it again. Name it take 2, take 3, take 15, whatever. Your professor's not going to count it against you that you recorded it over and over again until you got it right. Just keep track of the name of the proper recording, the one that you ended with, the one that you liked, and make sure that's the one that you send the name of to your professor. Jason? Thanks, Jason. Now let's talk about technology for a moment. One of the things we suggest when you're working online is to use a headset microphone if you're going to be speaking. This cuts out on some of the feedback that you'll get if you're working with someone else and their microphone is open and both of you have a microphone near a speaker. Quick hint, if you've got some feedback that you're hearing, the person who's not hearing the feedback is most likely the person that's causing it. Using a headset microphone will cut out on that feedback. Also, it oftentimes provides a clearer audio signal than the microphone that's built into your laptop. So get a headset microphone. Jason?
Thanks, Jason. Another thing you're going to want to do is make sure you go through the audio setup wizard. This makes sure that you're using the proper microphone that you can hear others as they're speaking. But the other thing it does is it sets the levels of the microphone so that you can make sure that your sound is being heard on basically the same playing field as the others. You're not too soft and you're not too loud compared to others. Jason?
Thanks, Jason. One last thing about microphones. When it's not your turn, make sure you mute your microphone. Make sure you turn that off so we're not hearing any sort of background sounds. You may not realize it, but you can hear your breathing oftentimes. You can hear other things going on in the background. And it can become a distraction, not just to the presentation and the person watching the presentation, but it can become a distraction to the person who's trying to make the presentation. Jason?
Thanks, Jason. So to review, make sure your technology is set up and working properly, particularly your microphone. Go through a dress rehearsal to work out whatever kinks you might have in your presentation. And if you're recording your presentation, record it as many times as you need to make sure you get it right. Good luck
and have a fantastic presentation.